Okay, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. So today I'm going to show you how to get started with Bootstrap, and then we're going to just add a few elements. So I'm going to show you how easy it can be just developing with Bootstrap. We are going to be doing a lot of copying and pasting from the website you see me in, because this is where we get Bootstrap components, and this I believe is the best way for you guys to kind of like jump into Bootstrap. This here is version 4.3. So I'm going to start with that. I don't have a problem you trying to get started with Bootstrap 4 or Bootstrap 5 or any kind of version you want, even 3, because they're basically more or less the same thing. Okay, so just gonna take a quick call. Okay, sorry about that, you guys, I was just interrupted up for a second. Okay, so let's get back to it. So I'm going to start with a very blank page this time. Okay, so what I'm going to do is copy this starter template, and then I'm going to explain what every section is talking about. So I'm going to open up our folder. I'm going to open up our folder real quick, and then I'm going to open this file, and I'm going to delete everything on that file. Okay, now I'm going to copy this, I'm going to paste it right there. Okay, and then I'm going to explain what all these elements are, starting from the head. Like I had told you before, these are just the metadata. So you can see the viewport, content, and etc. You don't really have to focus on that right now. The part you need to focus on is this Bootstrap CSS. So this is the link to our Bootstrap CSS file. This is where the CSS is being stored. And then this is our title. It just says hello world. And then these are our Bootstrap JavaScript components. And I've just realized I need to show you guys why we put links that look like this. So like I told you before, we could be writing our own CSS inside here. We could open this place and say style, and then kind of like just jump in and add our styling here, and you know, and things will just happen the way they should be happening. For example, if I load this page on our browser right now, just right click here and I say open it Google Chrome. So as you can see, it's just a plain white background with the text hello world. Okay, now I want to, okay, I'm going to switch this windows like this, it's more comfortable for me. I want to show you guys how CSS is stored outside the web page itself. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to call it, I'm going to save it and say style.css. Okay, I'm going to save that here. So this is our local CSS file. What it is that instead of writing our styling over here, I'm just going to use a link like this here. So I'm going to say I want a link and of that type and everything, and then in the href, this is where I'm going to point our CSS file, style.css. okay, and now to demonstrate how that works is I'm going to come here and I'm going to put some CSS styling for body. I'm going to say background color, and I'm going to put it at red, just so you can see how it works. And if I refresh this page, you can see our background turns to red. So in turn, when you want, so I'm going to get rid of that. So in turn, when you want to have styling from elsewhere, instead of, you could maybe download this file, put it in your localhost, and just reference it the way this has been done here. Like say you had this, the Bootstrap CSS file on your machine, you could just reference it the same way we have done the style.css. So in this case, we just want to access the file from a CDN here called stackpath, and the JavaScript files over here. I'm going to explain to you guys what these JavaScript files are for and what they do. Okay, Another thing I would like to maybe do or look at would be to adding fonts, or rather an icon font. We're going to be using Font Awesome, and I'm going to show you how you can add icons to your web pages here and there. Okay, so now what we are going to do next is, for example, we're going to open up the link we were to build something that looks like. I don't know if you guys remember that. Okay, so I'm going to open this, and this is just going to guide us. We're not going to build exactly something like this, but we are going to try and do what they've done here. Okay, another thing I want to show you guys how to do is how to add fonts. So I'm going to open up here Google Fonts. And then we're going to look for a font that we like. Okay. Personally, I like Roboto. So I think I'm just going to go with this. Okay. And then I'm going to select the fonts that I want. I usually just select all of them. Okay. Just select all of them. That, and then we're just going to copy the link that is generated right there. I hope you guys are seeing that. Okay, we're just going to paste that link right below the Bootstrap link. Okay, so something else you guys need to know is that the way that cascaded style sheets work is that the one that is rendered the last is the final say. So if I had a class here, and I had a class and I called it example.example, and I say background color is red, and then I came down here and had .example2.example again, and I say background color is blue. Okay, the element with the class example is going to be having a background color of blue. That is because the last CSS script is what will count. If you had styling on top of it and you came and wrote this, this is going to overwrite previous styling that you had up here. But if I did, for example, say color, and I said the color should be white here, and I didn't mention the color here, the color will still remain white, okay? So that's a good way of when you don't want to go, when you want to override styles like from Bootstrap, and I'm going to show you how in just a few. So what we want to do here is add a navigation bar, okay? And we want to, okay, we have added our font, so we have to do this on our CSS style. Almost forgot that. So we come to our style.css, and we're going to open up the body tag, and we are going to globally assign our font family to Roboto. So if I refreshed our page here, you will notice that our font sort of like changes a bit. Okay, yeah, so we are done with the fonts. We can just close that out, and then now we want to create sort of like a header, a landing page over here. Okay, so we are not going to do this cool effect for now. What we are going to do, we are going to make a static header, okay, right here, that is just going to have the navigation bar and a photo here and some text here, and maybe just add an icon over here, okay. So what we are going to do is go back to the Bootstrap here, and we're going to say we want some components, okay. And then we're going to find a navigation bar here. Okay. Then we're going to select the easiest navigation bar here, and we're going to copy that up. And we're going to paste it right over here. Okay. So now we have a navigation bar, but we kind of want our navigation bar to have, okay. So what we're going to do next is create somewhere where we're going to have our big image, okay? So we're going to create that div over here. I'm going to zoom this in just a bit. So remember, this is the code we copied from for the navigation bar. So this is just going to look the way exactly the way it is as we copied it. So if I refresh this here, you can see we have just the stock Bootstrap navigation bar up here with the search, but this doesn't do anything as of now. So what we want to do next is create this section with the background image. Okay, so we are going to use our background image, the one that we had downloaded, and what we are going to do is create one div, and in this div we're just going to assign a background image for it. So we're going to give it a class and call it big background. Okay, then we're going to our CSS style and get that class big pg, and we're going to say background image, and it's going to say URL, then we're going to point it to this image.jpg like so. Okay, and we're going to give this class, we're going to open up another div inside here, and you're going to see why I need another div here in just a few seconds. So what we need to do is that we have our image, but we need it to be a bit dark so that our white text can be seen the way they've done it here. So you can see that this image is exposed, it has a lot of white, but they needed the white text still to be seen. So what we're going to do is we're going to create another div over here, and in this div we're going to assign a class, okay, and we're going to call it big bg inside. Okay, then we're going to copy this class, okay, and we're going to paste it here, and we're going to say our background color, okay, is, you're going to use RGBA. This stands for red, green, blue, and alpha. So we're going to give it a black color, but we are going to reduce the opacity to point, say 2. Okay? And then what we need to do next is have a div in here that will now hold the text. Okay? Then we're going to call this class and we say wrapper div. Okay? And then we're going to say dot wrapper div. And we're going to say it has a padding, okay, and the padding top and bottom, let's give it say 30 pixels, okay, or let's say 40 pixels, and on the left doesn't really matter, so we're just going to say 0 pixels over here, okay, and then now here we're going to put our text. So it's going to be, we're just going to copy this, and we're going to write, we're going to make it a h1 so that it's just big, and we're going to put the text over there, and then below it we're just going to add a small paragraph. So we could just do a paragraph, just add the text in there. Okay, now we want to style the text in here, okay. And what we can do is assign both of these classes a Bootstrap class. We call it text light, which gives the text a light color. Okay, so we could just say class and say text light. Okay, and the text will automatically be white. And then we'd want the text to be aligned, so we'd say text center. So these are just Bootstrap classes that you guys can go and look into. So when we refresh our page, what do we get? We get something that looks like this. So clearly we need our image to be much, much bigger than this. Yeah, we really do need our image to be much bigger than that. And what else do we need? We need to break our text somewhere around here, okay? So for breaking our text, we're just going to come here and add a break line, okay, and then our div, we're going to add some padding and maybe say 200 pixels top and bottom. Then we're going to refresh that, and we can say we have something almost close to this. Another trick I'm going to show you guys is how you guys can just sort of like debug your website or build on top of your website, you know, on the browser, so that before you go and test it out on the actual CSS. For example, when we're here, we'd want to know what size would work well with our text, okay? So for example, we will inspect this and we will find the text, and then we're going to play around with the font size. So we could play around with the font size right here on our console and say font size 16 pixel, and see, that doesn't work for us. And we could say maybe 24 pixels, and we'll be like, yeah, that kind of works for us, okay? So now we go to this text, and now because we know our font size, we'd say para text. Okay, so this is my custom class which I'm going to define here. So, and I'm going to say dot para text, and I'm going to give it the styling that I saw worked for us here, which is font size 26 pixels. Note that if I reload this, our text will go back to its original size, because this doesn't save anything, it just alters the code that is being rendered by the browser. So I'm going to just add the font size here. I'm going to say 26 pixels. Okay, then I'm going to do the same thing with the header text over here. I'm going to inspect that, and I'm going to try say font size say 48 pixel. And we'll see, like, yeah, that kind of works for us. We maybe want to add a font weight, and we'd say maybe, let's see which one works for us. I think that one, that's 800. So we'd want to say bold. So the bold font weight, and we'll come here and give our header text a class, a custom class, and say header text. And head over here to our CSS file and say dot header text, and say font weight bold. Okay, then if we refresh our page, you can see we kind of get something that looks like this. Okay, and we wanted to add our font size also, so we put our font size at 48 pixel. Okay, so it should look something like this. Yeah, it would look something like this. Now remember, our photo was a very large photo. If I will just take you back to where it is and open it up, you can see that our photo is much bigger than that. Our page only covers a very small section of the photo. So what we want to do is kind of like make this section only focus on the center of this image and zoom it out accordingly, or zoom it in accordingly. So what we'd want to do is come to the class where the photo is, that is this class, okay, and we want to style the background. So we'd say background size, and we'd say cover, and then I'm going to say background position. And we're going to say center. And then we want our image to be parallax. You can see that when you scroll up here, this image does not move at all. Okay. So what we want to do for that is to say that the background attachment, this is fixed. Okay. And then another thing we want to do is prevent the image from repeating itself. Okay, so the way to cover the screen is to just zoom in and out accordingly. So what we're going to do is say background repeat, and say no repeat. Okay, so let's see our image now. So when we refresh, you can see that our image is now focused, is now zoomed out a bit, and you can now see a very a bigger portion of the image. Okay. Now, something else we want to do is maybe sort of like see if our navigation bar could be transparent. And like I told you guys, you don't have to go right to your code. You could just come and inspect over here and kind of like check our nav and see it has a background color. And what happens if you put it to transparent? Okay, and you see that it remains white. Okay, and then if, for example, I wanted to try out something and I didn't know if it's going to work, so I'd come here and I'd inspect this BG. Okay, and I'd say, what if I made it have a negative margin? Okay, and say margin top, and I'd say negative 100 pixel, and voila. So now our navigation bar is inside our header image. Okay, and then what if also I wanted now our text to be kind of like to be brighter, you know, because our image is already here and we need it to be white text like so. And remember, on Bootstrap you could have a way to toggle between dark and light navigation bars. If you scroll down here, you will find exactly like this. So by just specifying BG dark, you'd have a dark navbar. BG primary would have a primary colored navbar. So this blue is the primary color for by default for Bootstrap. So if you have anything as primary, if you allocate any color as primary, this is the kind of color you're going to expect. I'm going to talk about themes later where you can customize your primary colors, secondary colors, even your alert colors. So what we want is so that our border, our navigation bar will have light text, we'd want it to be a BG dark board navigation. Okay, so I'm going to find where they put that class there, and I'm just going to change this to BG dark. Okay, and when I refresh this, okay, so remember we only did the margin change on the console, so it didn't reflect, so we have to go back and sort of like change this this margin on our CSS file. So we are going to go to this guy here and we're going to say margin top, and we're going to say negative 100 pixels. And then another thing we want to do is we want this background to be transparent. So we know the BG class is the one that assigns the background color to the navigation bar. So on the BG class, we're going to come and override the background color. Okay, so BG dark, but maybe we want to override this only in this div, because we might want to use the BG dark as it is on other divs. Okay, so what we'd want to do is we will say that we only want to alter the BG dark for the nav element. Okay, so we are going to do it like so, and then we're going to say background color and call it transparent. Okay, then we're going to refresh this, and seems that our background color did not appear here. Let's just look at what's going on here. Okay, so this has been set to important. Okay, so if you want to override this, you would probably have to assign your value as important also. So we're just going to add important over there, and we reload that, and we do not get that. Okay, okay, so I hope you guys have seen where we had some kind of mishap. So it has there can't be some space here, so it should be nav.bg dark, and then we'd have the bg dark for the nav only to appear like so. Okay, I think we have another problem over here, because our text is still not kind of like, it's still not white. Okay, and we wanted our text to be white. So let's just take a look at the classes that have been given here, and we're going to change this to navbar dark also. Okay, we had forgotten to do that, and now we have our text like so. I don't think we need the search. We don't need the search. We don't need this search button. But we can just keep it there for good looks, okay? And now we want to have sort of like an icon image over here that looks like kind of like this one, okay? That looks kind of like this one, but we're not going to animate it really, okay? So let's go look for an icon. I'm going to show you another cool site that I use for development. It's called Flat Icons, okay? Just going to go here. They have some premium icons and they also have some free icons, so you guys can just choose. And we are looking for a play icon, okay? And it's going to give us a bunch of play icons, and we want a cool looking icon over here, so let's probably take this one here, okay? Okay, and then we want to locate this. We're going to copy this. I'm going to take it back to our folder over here. I'm going to put it on tutorial one, like so. Okay, and then now we're going to put this icon on our code. Okay. So we're just going to go right below this place here, and we are going to put a paragraph, and inside this paragraph we're going to put an image, and the image is going to be play.png, and we are going to give it a class. We're going to call it play icon, okay? And we're going to go to our CSS class and say that play icon, and say it will have a height of only 60 pixels, okay, and a width of auto. Or should it be the other way around? A height of auto and a width of 60 pixels. I think that's going to work better, okay? And so we're going to look if that worked, okay? I can see the image is there. But we want it also to be centered. So we're going to assign a class here and say text center this. Okay. And we're going to refresh that and we're going to see our icon over there. Okay. I feel like the colors from this background are interfering with our code. So what we are going to do is just inspect this. Then we're going to find the div where we put our opacity, and we gave it an opacity of 0.2, okay? So we want to give this 0.5, okay? 0.5, does 0.5 look like? Okay, I think this works perfectly. So we're going to give that 0.5, and now we have our page looking like that, okay? Something else we will probably want to do is add the padding for our guy here, because I remember we margined it up, so we'd probably want to have the padding over here a bit more to around 240 pixels and have something like that, but I still feel like that is still not balanced, so I'm going to just drop a div, and I'm going to give it a margin top of 40 pixels so that you can have it look something like that, okay? Yeah, something like that. Or we could also give the whole big BG thing a height of 100 vertical height, just for good looks. So this will cover the whole screen, so yeah, something that looks like that. And you know, kind of like I think we're maybe going to have to draw with this, and we're going to have our navbar inside of this, okay? So I think you guys can tell that this is probably the life of development. Sometimes things don't work out and you have to play around with them until they work out the way you want them to work out, okay? So you can see that is looking good and we don't want this here. Yeah, yeah, and we have something like that. Okay, okay. I think we want this to be inside the opacity zone. So we're also still going to move it back down here. Okay. So yeah, we're going to have something that looks like that. Looks like that. I think we can work with this. I think this is okay. And just going to reduce that. Okay, so the wrapper div is also needs to have a height of 100 VH. Then this guy needs to lose it. Okay, now that makes sense, okay? And the wrapper div needs to have a padding top of 240 pixels. Nope, that's not gonna work. We need this guy here to just have a margin top of, say, 4. So that's a Bootstrap class, you guys, but that doesn't seem to work. So what we want to do is, in the header text, we want it to have a margin top of 200 pixels and make it important. Okay, so we want it to have, so we're going to the header text over here and we're going to say margin top of 200 pixels, and then that's the way we want it. Okay, so as you can see, we have managed to create something that looks almost like this. Okay, it's only, I think it's a bit long, okay, so we have that. Okay, now I don't think this 100 VH thing works for me that well. Let's do 80. Maybe let's do 60. Yeah, see, now that makes sense. Okay. Yeah, so guys, I hope you've seen that a lot of iterations required. Okay, so another thing I will maybe want us to do is create this section here, and I think that will be all for today. And then maybe next time we could go down to the services and then to the call to action. So we just want to create a small title here, maybe make it spaced out the way they've done here. Okay, and there's something we need to add here. Okay, we have something we call containers. Okay, this is what we call containers. So in our divs, when we want things to be aligned to a certain height, no matter the screen we are on, we come and give it a container so that you don't have this looking like it's starting from the edge kabisa, and then this looks like it has some padding over here. So when we go here to our divs here, where we had our navbar, okay, this navbar, yeah, what we want to do is create another div here, and then we want to close the div right after the unordered list. Okay, and in fact we'll put it at the wrong place. We want to put it here. Okay, I want to put it, not that, we want to put the div here. Then this div, we are going to give it a class of container, and I'm going to show you why we are doing this in just a few. Okay, we are going to look for where this nav ends, and we are going to add the div, close the div right there. And when you refresh, you can see that the content now starts at this line. So even our text here, when we wrap our text in another div, we give this div the class container, and we assign the div, we put the div inside the container class. And when we save, you can see that the hello world now comes a bit padded inside, okay? So we want to create this paragraph in these two columns. So we are just going to start with the paragraph and maybe create this underline over here. So the paragraph starts with a tag like the one we're using, the hello world, but they've called theirs about us. So we could maybe change this and call this about us. Okay. And then we're going to add a small div that we're going to use to style this out. But first, our container here, we'd want it to have some padding, okay? So we're going to say py, and we're going to say 4. So what py stands for is padding for the y axis. So 4 is a very high figure. It starts from py1, py2, py4, but that calculates relatively based on the screen you're on, okay? So about us, we're going to create a small div here. And then this div, we're going to call it, going to give it a class and call it divider div. Okay, then we're going to style it over here, dot divider div. Okay, and for the divider div, what we want to do is make it very small in width. Okay, so we're going to give it a width of something like 10%. Okay, and then we're going to give it a height of something like 4 pixels. Okay, and then I'm going to give it a background color of green. Let me show you. I think I have already shown you this, how to pick colors from other web pages. You can use this cool tool here, it's called ColorZilla. So you can pick a color from a page like this, like so. Just pick this color and we come and give it to our divider div. And then we're going to look and see if it worked. And yes, we have a small line under our about us. So I'm just going to reduce the percentage here and say 5%. And I think we're good. I think we're solid. And then we're going to say a margin top of 20 pixels and a margin bottom of, say, the same 20 pixels. Okay. Refresh that and we have something of the sort. Let's make top 10 pixels so that it can look like it's underlining it. Okay, and then now we're going to add our paragraph over here outside the div, remember. So we're going to put a paragraph here. We're just going to copy what they've done here because it's just placeholder text, and we're going to paste it there. Next, we want to create two columns, okay, and maybe this button. And I'm going to show you how we're going to create this button too. So let's create these two columns. So what we do with columns in Bootstrap is fairly simple. What you want to do is, and I'm going to show you, so when you're writing your code, it's also good to comment so that people can know where you're starting and where you're finishing, sort of like elements or segments in the code or something like that, just for good looks. So we're going to say the row section. Okay, so what we want to do here is to create a div, and in this div we're going to give it a class, and the class is going to be row. Okay, this is going to specify that this div is a row. Then we're going to put two classes here. These classes, we're going to give them classes, and these are just Bootstrap predefined classes, okay? This is column for medium devices, 6. That is 6 columns out of 12. It's going to be half the screen, okay? Then you're going to copy this and paste it here. Okay, you're going to do a small paragraph over here. Just going to do a, just put the text there, or not. Let's do a paragraph. Put it there. Okay, and then we are going to do a list. So they have an ordered list over here. Just going to do an ordered list. We are just going to use our normal bullets. I will show you maybe later how to incorporate some cool looking icons like these ones. So we just have three items. So we are going to do a list item, and I'm just going to paste this first one over here and replicate this three times. Okay. And then we're going to go to the second column, and we're just going to create this paragraph. Okay. Paste that there. Then below here, we're going to create a button. Okay. We're going to give this class a custom button. Okay. So this is because we don't have a Bootstrap class that can customize your button like this. So we want to do it ourselves. Okay. So the text here is learn more, and as you can see, before when we hover it changes, but before we hover it's just a white button with a green border. Okay, so let's go do that. So we're going to copy this custom button, and we're going to place it here. Okay. And then you're going to say it's obviously that background, and then we're going to give it a border. We're going to say 2 pixels solid, and you're going to give it this color. This is, remember, this is the green we stole. Okay, and then we're going to give it a padding, and for the top to bottom we give it 10 pixels, and for left and right we give it say 20 pixels. Okay. And then we give it a color of this too. Okay. And when we refresh this, we have a button that doesn't look so similar to the other button. And here's how we can change that. We are missing a border radius. Yeah. And the background doesn't really look like it's white. So we need to make sure it's a white background. So our background color has to be of white color, and then we need the padding on the left and right sides to increase to 30. Okay, and our border radius of 15 pixels. Okay, let's see how that looks like. Not so much. Let's do 25 pixels. And we have something close to what they have over here. I think if we reduced our top paddings to 5, yeah, we have something of the sort. Note that it doesn't change when we hover, okay? But we want it to change, okay? So this is how you do that. You copy this, paste it here, and give it this attribute, and say this is what should happen when you hover. The border should remain the same. The background color, however, should not be white. It should be this color. And the color should not be this. It should be white. Okay? Everything else should remain the same. So basically, we'd want to get rid of that. We'd want to get rid of the padding because these don't change. Okay? And when we hover over this now, you can see it becomes inverted. Okay? But now we want it to happen smoothly, so we need to give it a transition effect. Okay, and then we're going to say all 0.3 seconds is okay. And then when we refresh that, and you can see that it does it much more smoother. Okay, it does it much more smooth. Okay, so this has been a very long tutorial, and I would like to stop at that. I think that's good for our first Bootstrap day, and I hope that we are going to do much more when we get back to this. Okay, so just a recap, we have seen how to install Bootstrap, We have seen how to import elements from the Bootstrap documentation. Instead of going to have to create your own navigation bar, just go and pick the snippets from the Bootstrap documentation, come and override their code, make it look like you own it, okay? Yeah, so that is what Bootstrap does. It's a very nice and powerful front-end framework. So we are going to leave it at that today. I hope you guys are going to keep it chill, keep it cool. Stay healthy, y'all. Stay alive, okay? Cheers.